Good morning, Paul.
Hey,
This
Larissa.
morning we have Paul Prior from Toronto and Region Conservation Authority, one of our wildlife biologists who conducts breeding bird surveys and also surveys of breeding frogs and toads across Toronto and region. So you are done breeding bird season. The birds are pretty much finished doing what they need to do to breed.
Well, from here on out, the singing becomes very sporadic. And for us to get the most effective use of our time, we want maximum singing. And that pretty much happens through much of late May and June. You can hear there's a bit of bird song going on at the moment here, yellow warblers. There's even an American red start, actually, which is what I was looking for as a catbird. So, you know, stuff is certainly still going on, even though the singing's finished. There's a lot of feeding going on. That there, that's the American red, that red start, that sort of. Again.
What are some of the unique finds that you found this year? Some of the birds that you got really excited about. Can you tell us about, recap the season for us, Paul?
We know hooded warbler is doing fairly well in some of the other locations on the moraine. But now we're also getting some good numbers up in the northwest sort of Caledon area. So that's really quite exciting. It was until, I think, I don't know, 2014, 15, it was considered a species of special concern by the province. But now it's been downgraded because its numbers are going up. Merlin's another good news story. Well, good news if you're not a house sparrow or some sort of feeder bird. Wonderful birds. And before about, I think, maybe 4 or 5 years ago, we did not have any breeding records for the city at all. But it's a very dynamic little falcon. And I think previously it was always associated with very rural cottage country, that sort of thing. But I know of 5 or 6 locations over the last couple of years within the actual city of Toronto.
Thank you for sharing those good news stories. What would be your advice for anyone living in the city who'd like to help breeding birds and other wildlife species?
Stay on the trails, have some sort of understanding and awareness of the fact that you're actually in the homes of many different species. Just come up on the screen there. That's actually I think that's the hooded warbler nest from last year. Yeah, that's only a couple of feet off the ground. So, and it was incredibly close to a trail. So, a charging dog just having fun could cause considerable damage and stress and alarm to these species. As far as stuff you can do in your own backyard, planting native is great. We have a native garden at home, and it's proven to be just fantastic for all the pollinators, which in turn means it's a ready food supply for a lot of the insectivorous birds. And as I say, insectivorous, even some of the seed-eating birds, sparrows and such, are largely insectivorous during those early days of feeding fledglings and feeding young, because it's high protein. So anything which increases the numbers or the density of insects and bugs is great.
Okay, excellent. Well, have a wonderful morning, and thank you again for your time, and we will chat soon.
Pleasure. All right, okay, cheers.
Bye. Bye-bye.